Finally, Coach has made it back home. Finally. Alright, welcome back to the channel. And you know, this series has been longer than expected. It's my top 10 most influential Ravens over this 2021 season. And today we're doing number 7. Now, I promised to get all these out to you before August the 2nd, and that is going to happen. So they're going to kind of speedball through your YouTube network, so to speak. So if you have not hit that bell notification for unsubscriptions, you need to do that, because they're coming fast and furious over these next 2 days, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. This will be done by Sunday night. So make sure you hit that bell notification so you can be notified when they drop, so you can kind of get it in. And if you sent the list in, we can see who matches up with who. All right, but to number 7, let's recap the 10 through 8 so far. Number 10 was Jimmy Smith. Number 9 was Rashad Bateman. Number 8 was Justin Madubuike. The 3 honorable mentions were J.K. Dobbins, Gus Edwards, and Mark Andrews. Number 7. This is a perfect time to give this video a thumbs up. And while you're down there, make sure you go ahead and click that subscribe button. Thanks. Marlon Humphreys. Probably one of the best corners in the NFL right now. And the reason he's not higher is because this is the most influential or the most impactful Ravens for this year. So reason I say that, because if he goes out, we still have enough guys to manage while he's out. I'm not saying if he goes out, we'll still be top tier in the defensive secondary, but we got guys to manage and maybe, you know, work some wins and some matchups if he goes out. But he's number 7 on this list, and let's kind of talk about his stats from last year. 2020, pull it up real quick. Played 15 of 17 games. Had only one interception. Reason being, he only had one interception. A lot of people don't throw it. And if they do, it's some kind of underneath drag stuff that happens real quick. And when that happens, then he turns into Marlon the Puncher. So as far as forced fumbles, eight. I'd be willing to bet. I don't know if I could pull that up anywhere, but that's probably number 1 among DBs, if not number 1 in the NFL as far as forced fumbles. And that's, you know, that along with his coverage skills, along with the ability to play the ball when given the chance. His tackling, how many tackles did he have? 82 tackles. That's a lot for a DB. Yeah, 82 tackles. 4 tackle for losses. Remember I talked about Peters a couple weeks ago, and I talked about a play where he lined up. The offense had a tight formation, and Peters just came in and went and got the tackle in the backfield. Marlon does the same thing. He just does that a little bit better. So you're looking at a guy that has A1 coverage skills, not afraid to tackle, has ball skills, and once you make the catch, just because you make it don't necessarily mean you're going to finish that play with the ball. Because I don't want to say he's perfected it, but he's put a new deal on the peanut punch. We got to find a way. I guess we're going to call it fruit punch still, even though he changed his name. Marlon had 8 fruit punches, you know, and some of them created big plays. If I'm not mistaken, correct me if I'm wrong in the chat box. The Chuck Clark, no, that was Peters. That was Peters. I was going to say the Chuck Clark, and that was Peters. But the one that stands out to me is I think Juju caught a ball, Marlon punched it out, and somebody picked it up and scored. Maybe Marlon even picked it up and scored. But the fact that he can cause turnovers and wreak havoc, that's why he's one of the most influential Ravens on, you know, for this coming year. Not just cover skills, not just playing the ball, but the ability to punch the ball out and make it be a turnover or potentially be a turnover. More possessions equals more scoring equals most of the time more wins. If you can get more possessions than the opponent or steal a quick possession from them, whether it be onside kick, muff pass, interception, fumble, anything that can get the offensive ball again betters your chance of winning. And Marlon's number 7 on this list because he does a good job of that happening. Of those, he had 1 interception, 8 forced fumbles. I don't know how many of those forced fumbles were the Ravens got, but that's a big number. And I think I'm going to look it up after this is over and see who led the league in forced fumbles. And you know, if you beat me to it, put it in the chat, put it in the comments below. But number seven on the list, Marlon Humphreys. And, you know, on a different note, I don't know what NFL is doing with this All 22, but they are tripping. But that Marlon's number seven. So on the list, I'm going to run it down real quick and get up out of here so we can start on number six. 10 is Jimmy Smith. And what kind of question were they asking that man about him, his situation? Why make him relive that? That's stupid. Yep. Number eight, Bateman. Heard a lot of good things about Bateman coming out of practice. I think my guy Dubs is working with them guys and getting them better. And, you know, the different reports coming out of camp that the receivers are looking pretty good, even without Lamar being there. Huntley and McSorley seem to be throwing a lot of ball, throwing a lot of touchdowns, defense making plays too. But they seem to be, you know, getting good reps even without Lamar being there. Number eight was Madubuike. I hadn't heard a lot about Madubuike. I think maybe Ken put something about Madubuike on his Twitter feed today. I have to go back and check that. But again, I'm back home. The rest of the series is coming fast and furious. Number seven is Marlon Humphreys. And it really is self-explanatory. If you're a Ravens fan, you know how important Marlon is to us. I probably should be higher up on his list, but I'm going to try to explain to you why I got six other guys in front of him. See you when I see you. Peace. With the